It is impossible not to be impressed by the sheer grandeur, splendor, and power of the natural world. In this series, we will be honing in on one of the most magnificent and resilient species that planet Earth is home to. Found in every corner of the world, their sense of community, their fabulous mating and celebratory rituals, and their radical approach to love makes them one of the most exciting and diverse phenomena that planet Earth is home to. We will explore the many ways that they have adapted to life in the harshest of conditions. We will learn from their approach to acceptance and love, which defines their very existence. And we will reveal some of the sometimes bizarre and always sensational ways that they celebrate life, love, and each other. This is Queer Planet. Survival function. Often forced to dilute their true expressive natures in order to assimilate with the harsh climate of the city, this is a place where the queers can really let their guard down. Over the years, the queer community has developed a sort of language, physical signals with which they communicate with one another. This is the perfect environment in which to study them. Here, we have a fabulous plumage display known as the mullet. And here is a skin-tight vest which serves a dual purpose. It is both a symbol that the wearer is a member of the community, and it shows off those hard-earned muscles. And here, if we are very quiet and we are careful not to disturb them, we have a perfect example of what is known as a septum piercing. Often associated with rebel subcultures, this is a symbol that the wearer refuses to conform. The social structures and hierarchies here are fascinating. Here we have the Queen Mother. Recognizable by the height of her heels, the poise with which she carries herself, and of course, the sheer number of rhinestones. Every Monday, the queers have been flocking to this watering hole in order to watch some of their brightest and best perform in a ritual known as drag. At the end of this 7-week grueling process, one will be crowned the most fabulous. To an outside, untrained eye, this ritual may seem frivolous, daft, inconsequential even. But these queers know otherwise. It is an expression of their pride and their liberation. It is a place where those who have been taught to feel like outsiders can come and find a home and a family. And be not just accepted, but celebrated for those very things that make them different. Move over, David Attenborough. There's a new nature king in town.